This is my first opportunity to greet you as Deputy Administrator of the National Aeronautics and Space Administration. It is a very great pleasure to introduce the Administrator of NASA, Dr. T. Keith Glennan.
Thank you, Hugh. The National Aeronautics and Space Administration. Established after long months of the most careful and earnest deliberation by the administration and the Congress, we must accelerate our development programs. We must acquire the vehicles that will carry our data gathering apparatus and ultimately man into space. Our prospects are both challenging and exciting. I know of no better way of summing up than to quote Senator Lyndon Johnson, chairman of the Special Committee on Space and Astronautics, who said during our August 14th confirmation hearing, and I quote this, "There are no blueprints or roadmaps which clearly mark out the course. The limits of the job are no less than the limits of the universe. And those are limits which can be stated but are virtually impossible to describe. In a sense, the course of the new agency can be compared to the voyage of Columbus to the New World. The only difference is that Columbus, with his charts drawn entirely from imagination, had a better idea of his destination than we possibly have when we step into outer space."
Liftoff of America's first space shuttle, and the shuttle has cleared the tower.